might have been a mistake. Oh, jeez. Yep. So this should set off another checkpoint, thankfully. One that will have me in a much better position to not get my ass kicked.
Bodies. Why?
Oh, gross. What is that? Alright. Let's get the hell out of here.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Totally not the way I should go.
Extraction arrived at meta base.
Alright. That's a checkpoint. Let's aim for, I don't know, like there. Looks like I can get out through here. Just keep running. Just had to do that.
You destroyed their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Yippee-ki-yay. This really messed with their day. These things are kind of fun. It'd be nice if I could move a little faster in them, but I wonder if there's going to be some sort of... I didn't see any child soldiers, so I don't know what that wrinkle was, but that is my next thing, right? Just escape. Yeah, exfiltrate the zone. That was weird, those bodies in the... in the muck. Hiya! CQC, robot style. I haven't seen D-Dog, so I'm just gonna assume that he's still right behind me. I also think that I picked like the furthest point. Like if I cut it across this way, yeah, I'll get out faster. I'll just do that. Maybe. Maybe that'll work.
Exfiltrated.
All right, you're
yes.
No enemy forces in pursuit. Mission complete.
Yeehaw. F rank. D rank. Four-toed hedgehog. Trumpeter hornbill. Oh, cool. I kept the walker gear.
Has been added.
Stealth camo. Auto ammo rack. Auto loader. Task arm. DWS pistol. DWD. Gatling gun.
Yes,
what is that all about?
Boss,
S rank? Oh, A rank. Okay. I was like, that's nuts. I guess I had no kills. I don't know what the bonuses are, but those were probably pretty tough. And honestly, if it wasn't for it changing my position at the checkpoint, I would have been fine. They just messed with it. And then what was I supposed to do, you know? Koji Pro.
Singer, the owner of the oil field. They were behind what happened. They hired the PF, not United. They restarted the facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Singer's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs. And get this. The fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation. Meaning someone is just using Saner's name from the shadows.
Gotta be Cypher.
But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?
Yeah, I have no idea what was that. What that was. Oh, we got more intel. D-Walk armament cannot be developed.
Hey, Snake, I've customized a walker gear just for you.
Is it the one that I took?
It's a silent running system, great for infiltration missions, and you can also summon it to your location.
That's pretty sweet.
I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker.
What?
It's armed with a suppressed tranquilizer gun.
Oh, sweet.
If you want to add other weaponry or upgrade the chassis, give the order from your iDroid.
That's awesome. I like the dog.
Captured it alive.
Great, four gerbils. There we go, hedgehogs. And trumpeter hornbills. That's why I got that. Soldiers, poster, Espanol. Gunsmith, grenade launchers. That's pretty good. I got a lot of good guys. Pirate Eagle, Fire Tiger, that's pretty good. Doom Moose, I like that. Doom Moose. Doom Shark, okay. Death Rooster, pretty cool. Death Cock. I wonder if it's going to take me to the ACC. I don't remember. I don't run. Oh, nope, it doesn't.
Boss, I've updated the mission list. We received a new job offer. It doesn't seem connected to Cypher or Skullface at all. But if it goes
it
well,
we
get
an
Afrikaans interpreter.
The details
are on your iDroid.
I need that. Legendary gunsmith. Materials containers. Tank units.
Please.
Is that what this is? Lingua franca. So what could I have done? Oh, there were four child soldiers being trained at Masa Village. I didn't see realize that. Exfiltrate the hot zone before Mifinda oil field was sealed off. Yeah. That's what I was going to do, but I messed up. Extracted a lapid face vulture that wandered into the burned down village. Extracted four walker gears. That would have been cool. Let us call in a helicopter pickup.
Helicopter.
I could have gotten out a lot faster, but would I have gotten out with a walker gear? Is there even a way that somebody could even know that? Water, water everywhere. Water, water in your hair. We'll get this guy. And then we'll go over to the helicopter. Bark. Pink. Yeah, I found a 2D dog. Both him and the intel team keep liking to take credit for things that I did. It's weird to have all this rain because I'm used to the desert not having like any of it. Pretty cool. Even more plants. Watching and waiting. She'll chew you up. Got it right that time. I don't have these guys back yet. 19 hours. So. Ooh, I want that. I have to go pick it up, excuse me. I don't even know what this is.
Support helicopter has arrived.
Pretty sweet. Watching and waiting. Get that other one back in the chamber. Alright, let's get out of here, D-Dog. You look wet. We're gonna have to figure out what we're gonna do about camo. I'm gonna be like quiet and like snipe a helicopter guy in the face. Whoa, here she comes. Watch out, boy, she'll eat you up. I always want to say eat.
Extraction.
Oh, copy. That's what I got. Yeah. Ooh, look at that GMP bonus. Sexy. Quick change.
Weather will clear shortly.
Let's look at the side ops that we have. So there's important ones. We already did that. Was the Afghanistan ones, which we might go back to. Angola Zaire. We actually should probably do that mission before we do any more Angola Zaire ones, just because we won't be able to do much without translators. My combat unit is full, so I guess I can add another one. What am I? Yeah, I'm not gonna get up to that on fuel anytime soon, but this uses fuel too. What is the base development right there? Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of far for me to get to. I mean, this is full, so.
Commencing platform
construction. Why not? And then let's go home.
Please select
and then we'll work on stuff. Where is Emmerich? I thought he was on the command platform, but I'm not sure. Well, I'll just pick command platform. It's gonna play like that really somber music when I'm coming in. Shock. Look at you, dog. He's so cute. Man, I don't want a dog like that. Yeah, you got all wet from all that rain. I gotta have Snake take a shower. Among other things. It's probably animals. Yeah, there's the hedgehog. There's the hornbill. It's like that one bird in Lion King. Domestic donkey. And then I'll copy. Alright, boys. Yeehaw. Nothing like raising morale by just bumping into people. I saw an anime poster I'm gonna have to take down. No.
What's up, boss?
Ooh, that was pretty good. I have no idea where all this stuff is, and nobody will tell me where it is. These aren't useful.
Spit it out. Thanks for that, boss.
Yeah. Let's play some tapes.
Sahelanthropus. Where does the name come from?
Well, several years ago, an excavation team discovered a hominid skull in the Sahel region.
Oh, cool.
Central Africa. The Southern Sahara.
Cypher gave the specimen the name Sahelanthropus. Man of Sahel. And then they covered the whole thing up.
Why?
They probably wanted to monopolize information about human evolution.
So Cypher's the one who found it?
In their genetic research. At least, until they had an idea of what they'd found.
It was that big of a discovery, huh?
Sahelanthropus was a gracile hominid, estimated to have lived about 7 million years ago. What's significant about it is how its skull's foramen magnum faces down. In
down.
Other words, its spinal column supported its head from underneath.
It stood upright.
Right. Which would mean Sahelanthropus walked upright 3 million years before Australopithecus, making it the world's oldest human species.
Walking upright. It's a hominid.
I get it. Hence the name Sahelanthropus for your machine.
Walking upright was the decisive difference between our ancestors and other anthropoids. Our brains could get heavier once they were supported by the spinal column.
Yeah.
That led to the use of tools and the development of complex communication through language.
Language.
Only man is capable of this. My creation will be the progenitor of all bipedal weapon platforms.
And you did this for Cypher?
No, not at all. Sahelanthropus is the best proof that I never betrayed you guys.
What do you mean?
The reconstructed Sahelanthropus skull looked exactly like the skull we used as our logo 9 years ago in the Caribbean.
An army without a nation. Outside the world order.
The design was based on Pangaea, the supercontinent that existed 250
years ago. Yeah, the MSF thing, yeah.
Right?
Yeah. When the world was a single landmass, that concept's at the source of our strength.
I felt the same way about Sahelanthropus. Sure, I was forced to build it under their orders, but I always wanted to put its technology back in our hands someday. That's the reason I incorporated the old insignia into Sahelanthropus' name.
I don't know. I don't know if I buy it.
That's how much I was thinking about you guys.
Oh, I see, all right.
It's desperate.
I see someone desperate to cover his ass. You can say whatever you want after the fact. But that skull also symbolizes somebody else. Skullface.
Yeah, Skullface. Flamethrowers.
Snake!
Stun guns.
You finally came. Just... don't record this, okay?
Not recording anything. What's this about?
What I'm about to say stays between you and me. It's about the weapon to surpass Metal Gear.
Yeah, Sahelanthropus.
You know a researcher by the name of Clark? He works in the biotech industry. Real advanced stuff.
Dr. Clark?
His area is bioengineering. But lately, he's also gotten into genetic research.
Never heard of him.
Well then, what do you know about cloning?
I think I've
Hang
heard
on
enough.
A second.
Hold on, this is important. Cloning lets you create a genetic copy of an organism.
That's really important. And I want to go over to her platform, Quiet's platform, but I don't want to interrupt the tape. Cloning.
Please select a delivery point.
What is it that we're going to talk about here? I have vague notions of who Dr. Clark is and what all of this is. I mean, Dr. Clark, they said it's he, but paramedic's last name is Clark. So I don't know if he just doesn't know that Dr. Clark is a woman. I don't know.
Take the nucleus of one of its cells, and you swap it with the nucleus of an unfertilized egg from another member of the same species.
Mm-hmm.
They started out working with plants, but since then they've had success with other organisms. Including mammals. It's a hot area for a lot of places right now. Corporations,
yeah, they clone the sheep.
Research groups. There's no shortage of scientists out to get famous and patent their work, with morality taking a back seat.
Isn't that a little outside your field?
It's got nothing to do with my research. But I thought it might be of interest to you. Cloning, and Dr. Clark, I mean.
Go on.
Now, this is really highly classified stuff, but I've heard that an American biotech company has successfully cloned a human being.
Who?
What's more, it happened over 10 years ago, and the researcher behind it was Dr. Clark. You've really never heard of him?
I don't.
Because it's not a man.
This Dr.
He knows
Clark
he knows paramedic.
Ghost, even to others in his field, his age, where he comes from. That might not be his real name, and I can't even say for sure he's a he. Clark's employer, ATGC, its company motto is embracing your hopes, preserving talent.
What does this have to do with me?
Cipher. Dr. Clark works for ATGC, and they have connections to DARPA. Cipher couldn't function without the communications network DARPA's built.
I'm not totally following.
Meaning, Cipher has to be a part of the Pentagon. Or at least, the two are joined at the hip. DARPA is a driving force behind human cloning. It's a pretty high priority project for them. And this Dr. Clark? Some say he's a pivotal player in Cipher. But that's not all. Every cell nucleus in an organism contains the genetic information for that organism. Think of it as a blueprint for life.
Yeah.
Clark appears to be working on how to decode this information and rearrange it at will.
Like gene therapy?
That, it would mean being able to custom design human beings for specific purposes. Can you believe that? Suppose for a moment that this is all fact. A man of your
talent.
It is all
fact.
If your genetic information died with you, that would be a terrible loss for mankind. But what if mankind could preserve you for future generations by cloning you?
All right, enough. I get the idea.
Look, I know it's inductive reasoning, but this weapon to surpass Metal Gear they're developing in Africa, I believe it's something that uses this new technology.
Cloning technology?
Speaking as a fellow scientist, it chills me to the bone.
That's rich coming from you.
Yeah.
If genes serve as our blueprint, then I wonder if they include an impulse that drives us to tweak the design. Can you imagine?
Interesting
that?
Theory.
Genes encoded with information that wants its children to decode it. Is life itself
like genetic memory?
The direction of our next evolution in the hands of scientists? I guess it would take some real arrogance to believe that. And yet, it could be what Cypher's after.
I think you're barking up the wrong tree. But that was an interesting story. It'd make a good movie.
You have to believe me.
Where's you hear?
He's gonna start torturing him again.
Where? I just overheard it in bits and pieces while I was forced to do that research for them.
Right.
He's so sketchy.
Wait a minute. Look, I want to help you. I want to be of service here. I'm risking my life with this.
Is that so? Maybe it's time we brought someone else into the conversation.
No, not him. Not Ocelot. You can't
He's a huge torturer.
Please select a delivery point.
It's very interesting to have, I guess that's the one that they're building, to have, so I guess these are all command platforms. I'm going to check some of the other ones to see if I find Dr. Emmerich. It's very interesting that they have made Huey Emmerich such a big character, and in this one is a much more controversial character than, you know, like... other manifest... I don't know, like... his family is going to be part of this game's story. I'll tell you that much. And, his presence in this game is not a friendly one. So it's just very interesting. Alright, so that's the second deck. That's the third deck. What's that? That's D-Dog. Let me check to see if, actually, I'm gonna do a cheaty kind of check. Let's go to google.com. Where is Huey's cell? Let me see. I don't want to get any spoilers for myself. No. Lower level of the command platform below the helipads. His door just to the right of that. So the helipads are over this way. Helipads? Oh. And like that area down there? Man, I would never have thought to go down there. Hey, D-Dog. I kind of almost did, but... did not. Snake got a little stuck there. This door one. Maybe he's on the other side. I'll try the other side, but if not, maybe I'm barking up the wrong tree. I'm glad you can't just, like, fall off, because I feel anxious about just, like, slipping and falling. They have signs like that. So far, no good. I don't even see a place where this lab could be. Maybe in there. Whoa. There's no wall there. Nothing doing there. And that's underneath one of the helipads. I don't think there are any helipads on these other ones. So, I mean, I can check all of these areas for it. But I don't know that I'm going to necessarily find it. Oh, that looks promising. Let's try and go to that. Whoa. Well, that was stupid.
Boss, what happened? Boss!
Yeah. You've got to be kidding me.
Dr. Clark works for AT. Cypher couldn't.
So obnoxious.
Oh. Maybe it's time we brought someone else into the conversation.
No, not him. Not Ocelot.
Not Ocelot.
You can't do this.
You can't do this. All right, be careful not to run off right here. I guess that's why they have all this safety stuff. I died in for nothing. There wasn't even anything there.
Please specify a project.
So stupid. Is that base facility still under construction? Yep. Alright, one more area to look. Look down here. Nope. Zilch. All I'm gonna end up doing is like running off the level again. I think I'm all the way back around to the front by the helipad. Yep, there it is. Let me check one more time. Okay, so I guess he's not actually here for me to visit, which is sad. I like visiting my friends.
Staff assigned.
We're gonna wanna do. Why didn't it mark as played?
Dr. Clark works for ATGC.
We're gonna wanna do one of. Well, what we're gonna wanna do is that side op to get the translator.
Meaning, but since. Part of the Pentagon. Or at least the two are joined at the hip.
We can't
DARPA
exactly do
is
that
a
yet.
Driving force behind human cloning.
Roger.
Let's call this in.
Priority project for them. And this Dr. Clark, some say he's a pivotal player.
Oh great. Input mapper just totally stopped working. So my controller's not working.
Think of it as a blueprint.
I'll just get in the chopper and then
Clark appears to be
that's where we'll save.
How to decode this information and rearrange it at will. If you could do that, it would mean
yep.
being able to custom design human beings for specific purposes. Can you
by the time I get to the ACC, that thing better of triggered
is
done.
Fact. A man of your talents, if your genetic information died with you, that would be a terrible loss for mankind.
Yeah, probably.
What if mankind could preserve you for future generations by cloning you?
All right, enough. I get the idea.
Look, I know it's inductive reasoning, but this weapon to surpass Metal Gear they're developing in Africa? I believe it's something that uses
yep.
this
smoke
new
smoke grenades everywhere.
Speaking as a fellow son.
It chills me to the bone. Bone. Bone zone. Weird that my controllers aren't working. Also, I don't know how to access the iDroid. Okay. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Easiest do re mi. Oh, I understand now. This tape hasn't played. Well, I say that'll be it for now. I'm just going to play this, and when it finishes, I'm going to quit out. Thanks for watching Dan Plays Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain. I'm Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain. This is Dan. I'll see you next time. Let's try and go to that. Well, that was stupid.